Hey, what's going on guys, my name is Alex and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to increase FPS, fix stuttering and crashing in Need for Speed Heat. And before I start, make sure you enable subtitles to my videos to understand better what I say. So yeah, let's start. This video idea was suggested by a fan and his name is Ardent G4mer. I'm sorry if I pronounced your name wrong, but here is the comment when he said that. And basically he wanted me to make a video on how to increase FPS, fix stuttering and other issues that he had. And in this video I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. And of course this video is not only for him, because if it was only for him, I would have sent him a personal video on his Gmail or anywhere else. And of course this video is for everyone else that has the same issue as him. So yeah, let's head right into what you need to do. In the description, I'll have three guides, which will be those ones right here. And at the top, I say that these guides may or may not work for everyone, so try all three of them. If you want my personal opinion, the first guide with NVIDIA settings worked the best for me. But do not head to the comment section right away because you have a Radeon GPU, because the first guide as well has a Radeon GPU as well. So if you have a Radeon GPU, the first guide will have it as well, and of course the NVIDIA settings as well. So in this video I'm not going to show you all three guides because this is going to be like a 20 or 30 minutes video and it's going to get quite boring, quite exhausting, and probably no one would even watch that. So I'm just going to show you the best settings that works for me. So head to the description, click the first link in the description, which will be the first guide right here. And if you scroll down to where it says change graphic card settings, and you scroll down a little bit again, you will see it says for NVIDIA users and for AMD users. And in a little bit I'm going to show you how to change those settings in the NVIDIA control panel. And since I do not have a Radeon GPU, I cannot show you how to change the settings, so unfortunately you have to do them by yourself, but it's not going to be difficult. And yeah, what you need to do with those AMD settings, you need to open your Radeon Control Center or Control Panel Center, however it's called, and you need to change whatever setting it says here to the settings that it needs to be. But for the NVIDIA users, what you need to do, you need to right click to the desktop and click NVIDIA Control Panel and give it a few seconds of course to load up. And here what you need to do, in the top left corner, you need to click the one that says Manage 3D Settings. Then you need to select the second tab that says Program Settings. Now here in the first one that says select a program to customize, here it's going to be something completely different. I'm not sure what it could be on your computer, but what you need to do, you need to click on top of it and you need to select Need for Speed Heat. If you do not find the game in this list right here, click where it says add and find the .dex file in the game's folder manually. And once you have found it and it's like that as I have it, what this guide said. And before I show you how to change the settings, if you have a G-Sync monitor, change that setting to G-Sync because this is going to be very worth it and you're going to like it, because G-Sync is going to make your game look way smoother than before. And if you have a G-Sync monitor and a G-Sync compatible graphics card, change that monitor tech setting to G-Sync if available. And since I do not have a G-Sync monitor, I do not have that setting and therefore I cannot change that setting. So if you see this setting, change the option to G-Sync. Now here what you need to do, you need to scroll down to the list and find the one that says Virtual Reality Pre-Render Frames. And here the default one is going to be 1 and you need to change it to 2. I'm going to go quick with those settings because I do not want to waste your time. The other option is going to be the Threaded Optimization. The default one is going to be on and you need to leave it on. And if it's not on, put it on, because basically at the bottom it says in the description, allows applications to take advantage of multiple CPU cores. So change that to on if it's not already. Then you need to change the power management mode setting to prefer maximum performance. I'm pretty sure the default one is going to be adaptive, but you need to change it to prefer maximum performance. And this setting basically makes your GPU use a little bit more power, so it can be up to par with your CPU. And the last setting is going to be texture filtering quality, and you need to change it to performance. I think the default one is going to be performance, but also there is a setting for high performance, but the quality will be a little bit crappier, but the FPS will be high. Not sure how much, but it could be around like 5 FPS or so. But if you want crappy quality but high FPS, choose that setting. If you want the opposite, put it to performance. And after you have changed all of those settings, Click apply, which will be in the bottom right corner, and give it a few seconds to apply those settings. Now, before I open the game and show you the internal game settings that you need to change, you need to right click through the shortcut of the game and click properties. Now you need to select the tab that says compatibility, and at the bottom you need to click the one that says change high DPI settings. Now the setting that we need to enable is going to be the bottom one that says override high DPI scaling behavior, scaling performed by application. If it's disabled like that, enable it and put it to application if it's not already. After that, click OK and apply and OK. And right now you can head to the game and try if those settings made a difference at all. If you want my personal opinion if this worked or not, I did see a very small improvement in FPS. It was not huge, it was around 2 to 5 FPS and the stuttering was fixed. You may say that this video is worthless because 2 to 5 FPS is basically nothing, but hear me out. If you have a CPU that's around 5 years old, that could work for your CPU because my CPU is 12 years old. And that's probably why the FPS did not increase, because I have a 12-year-old CPU and that game is not really for my CPU. So if you have a newer CPU, you could have a massive difference in performance. But if you do not, you can of course head to the other guides that I have in the description. Right now, I will show you two videos. The first one that says low settings without NVIDIA and DPI settings, and the other one says low settings with NVIDIA and DPI settings change. So basically, in the first clip, I have everything low in the game itself without changing any NVIDIA or DPI settings. And in the second clip, I have again low settings, but with NVIDIA and DPI settings change. I will show you these videos right now and you will see for yourself if you see any difference. And again, as I said, the difference is very small, but again, as I said, I have a 12-year-old CPU and that's probably why. Before I show you this video, you may say that why I don't open the game right now, because recording and playing at the same time is really, really hard for my CPU and it cannot handle it. So I cannot record with the game open and recording at the same time because the FPS will suffer quite a lot. So I'll play the first clip right now.
Hey, it's Lucas. You keeping busy?
Just enjoying some downtime.
Oh, nice. You know, I was gonna say, you know, people come to Palm City and they just think it's about downtown and the beach. Yeah, they should take a look around. Ease off the gas, enjoy the scenery, go up into the hills. Now, you can live here for years and still find new places. So don't get dragged into, you know, going from A to B all the time.
And as you saw in this clip, it's without the NVIDIA and DPI settings changed, but everything low. Now you will see the second clip, which will be every setting low, but with the NVIDIA and DPI settings changed. So you're going to see that clip right now. And as you saw, there wasn't a huge improvement, but there was a very small difference. Right now, you need to open the game and we need to head to the graphic settings of the game. So, I will see you in the game. Okay guys, right now we are in the game. And fun fact, many of you don't know if you are a subscriber, I recently got a new CPU cooler and the temps are looking mighty fine right now. I have overclocked my CPU to 3.6 GHz and I'm very happy with my choice. Anyways, what you need to do right now in the game, you need to head in the game settings and you need to head to the graphic settings. Right now, I'm pretty sure everyone knows that if you want the highest FPS possible, you need to change every single setting to the lowest possible, as I have it right here. I know this may not be the solution for many of you, but that's the best thing that you can do. Because of course, if you have it, for example, everything medium, the FPS will suffer quite a lot and you will not increase your FPS whatsoever. So that's basically basically the other solution that I got for you is like changing every setting to low or off, but leaving the resolution scale to 100%, because if you turn it down to like 70%, guys, you do not know how crappy the quality will be. I mean, I could show you right now, but I mean, you can try it for yourself if you have already the game opened, but the quality will be quite trash if you put it to lower resolution scale. So I would leave it to 100% so you can at least look at something. And yeah, that's everything it. I do not have anything else to show you. I'm sorry that this is not the best increased FPS video, but I have not played this game a lot and I do not know how well the FPS plays. And yeah, that's everything it. That's the video, guys. Thanks for watching. If you have any problems, tell me in the comment section. I'll try to help you as much as possible. If you have any video ideas, tell me in the comment section. I'll try to make them in the future. Thanks for watching, guys. Like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.